and all your success.
Thank you.
How, what's going through your mind? Has this all set in that you're successfully age and it's just taken off?
You know what? I think for me, it's kind of weird because it does feel a little bit surreal and everything feels like it's happened really fast. It all has happened really fast. But looking back on it, I don't know what else I'd be doing. So I'm glad this has happened and I get to play music for a living. So I'm just a happy person.
Talk about meeting the fans. You've done a couple of radio events today. You got to meet fans one-on-one. I mean, here they're out there, but radio events are special because it's very intimate. What are those like, and why is it special to connect with your fans?
Yeah, every once in a while we'll do some radio stuff and do like the small, you know, intimate kind of things, and they're actually really fun. You know, getting to talk to the fans, getting a lot of questions from them. It's fun to answer those, and they get to know a little bit more about you. So yeah, it's been really good.
Tell me about your musical journey. I mean, this just didn't happen by itself. Didn't happen overnight. How did this process happen?
You know, I've been playing music since I was probably 13 or so, getting into music, really loving music, and then started playing like at bars and stuff about when I was 18, playing for about 3 hours, making $50, and that's kind of how it is, I guess. And did that for a long time, writing music, made my own CD, and then. The whole thing with the American Idol thing happened, and the rest is history, I guess.
What is in your future? Where do you see this is going to keep on going? What are your dreams?
Yeah, my plan is to just keep on making music and hoping that it reaches more and more people, and just kind of doing what I want to do, and that's get on stage, play music for people, put everything that I have into it, and be the most successful musician that I can be.
Lastly, if there's any good story you can tell about meeting people or just connecting with the audience, I mean, what are the things that makes, I mean, music can be very personal.
Yeah.
Out here, it's very, you know, get a big stadium, but what are the stories that you can remember when you're actually touching somebody or can see in their eyes when you sing a song?
The best thing is when people are singing along to your songs, the songs that you write, you're playing into a big stage and there's hundreds of people, thousands of people singing your song. That's the best thing in the world, and you'll see people just dancing, or I've seen a couple people cry, and so it's a really cool thing.
How does that affect you emotionally?
It's great, you know, that people are relating to what you've gone through, or even just the words that you're singing, and it's great that you can bring that out of people. And I think we've had a couple stories of where people have a lot of people come to a lot of shows, and they say, you know what, you've gotten me through a lot, your music has gotten me through a lot. So that's all I can ask for, you know.